This evening's contest featuring your Western Washington University Vikings and Fresno Pacific University. Fans, prior to the announcement of our starting lineups, at this time would everyone please rise and remove your hats as we honor America by playing our national anthem. Now, fans, here are the starting lineups. First, for the visiting team, the Fresno Pacific University Sunbirds, as announced by their head coach, Tim Beauregard. Coach Beauregard is assisted by Scott Pissick and Katie Menton. Fans, let's welcome to the court number one, Bree Alvarez. Number three, Jessica Malazarte. Number 24, Ashley Cross. Number 30, Cassie Pissick. And number 32, Julia Locastro. Ladies and gentlemen, these are the Fresno Pacific University Sunbirds. Viking fans, are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise and meet our starters. This evening's lineup for your home team, Western Washington University Vikings, is announced by our head coach, Carmen Dolfo. Coach Dolfo is assisted by Stacy Terrell, Kayla Burnson, and Amanda Lance. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the court a 5'6" junior from Ellensburg, Washington, number three, Lexi Bland. A 5'7" junior from Seal Beach, California, number 10, Danny Iwami. A 5'11" sophomore from Tumwater, Washington, number 12, Emma Duff. A 5'11" senior from Auburn, Washington, number 33, Bobby Westendorf. And a 6'3" junior from Evergreen, Colorado, number 44, Anna Schwecki. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your Western Washington Vikings!
good evening, fans, and welcome to Western Washington University on the campus of the city of Bellingham University, Weeku Court. Join us for the last game here of this tournament here, the West Region Crossover Classic. Schools include Seattle Pacific, Humboldt State, Fresno Pacific, and your home team, Western Washington Vikings. My name is Sean Church, providing play-by-play for tonight's matchup. The game before us saw Humboldt State beat Seattle Pacific by a score of 79-77. And this game is going to start here right now. It's Fresno Pacific. It's a quick shot. Bland with the rebound. We are underway. As Yami gets the ball, gets it to Bland. And Bland, fadeaway shot off the front rim. Rebound, Schwecki puts it up and off the back rim. Rebound, Westendorf off. And a rebound by Emma Duff over to Yami for three. And they're going to get Yami with the travel. The turnover on the Vikings. It's Cassie Pissick, 13 points last night. She passes in. And Jessica Melzarte, 32 points last night, 7 of 13 from the three-point line. A great pass. Is it Schwecki with the rebound? Bland looks up, gets it to Duff. On transition, brings it back down to Westendorf. Backs her down over to Yami for three, and she hits it. Danny Yami with the three. Western up 3-0 early. Melzarte dribbling it down, guarded by Bland. Off the back rim, rebound Duff. It's Bland, cross court to Yami. Western trying to speed things up here. Westendorf backs down her man, cross court to Duff. Schwecki tries to seal off. Reverse layup by Duff, misses. Scramble for the ball, and it's going to be Western ball. See on this replay, Yami set up her feet nice on the corner, hits the three, and she has the ball right here, but that's going to be a foul on the floor, Fresno Pacific. Ashley Cross, that's her first foul, first team foul of the quarter. Yami's going to pass it in for the Vikings. Gets over to Bland. Reset of the shot clock here. Duff, top of the three-point line, over to Yami. Pump fakes, goes lefty. Passes it back out to Westendorf for three. Off the front rim and rebound. And there's a fight underneath. LaCastro and Schwecki. Possession arrow pointed towards the Vikings, and they're going to keep possession here. Yami passes it in for the Vikings. Knocked out. That one was last touched by Westendorf, so Fresno Pacific ball. Fresno Pacific yesterday beat Seattle Pacific by a score of 80-69. Melzarte for three off the front rim, rebound on the ground here. Schwecki. They're going to get Schwecki with the travel after the rebound, so Fresno Pacific will regain possession. The Sunbirds are coached by Tim Beauregard. It's his third season as head coach of Fresno Pacific. Pump fake. Over the cross. Faces up, guarded by Yami. Crossover dribble, gets it in the paint. Gets some contact. Looks like it was deflected off Schwecki, so Fresno Pacific will get the ball. 19 seconds left on the shot clock. Elzarte passes it in to Pisick. Over to Alvarez. Guarded by Duff. Looks for the screen by Pisick. Over to Elzarte. Off the front rim. Rebounded Western. So Yami gets the screen by Schwecki. They're going to get Schwecki with the moving screen. It's a foul on the Vikings. That's her first personal, first team foul. And she's going to take a seat here. Kelsey Rogers, a sophomore from Linwood High School in Bothell, is going to come in for Schwecki. Malasarte is going to dribble it down for Fresno Pacific. Malasarte with the layup. And now Fresno Pacific is on the board here. They trail 3-2 here early. Stuff looks to get it down to Rogers. Rogers, that one is taken away by Fresno Pacific. Cassie Pisick on transition gets over to Malasarte. No look pass back to Pisick. That was a great pass underneath off the front rim on the attempt by LaCastro. And that one is turned over, stolen by Fresno Pacific. Cross over to and another travel by Pisick. And coming into the game now is Isla Faber, the sophomore from Germany. She's going to replace LaCastro for Fresno Pacific. Bland, guarded by Cross, gets it back out. Crossover dribble by Iami. Knocked away, but they're going to get Cassie Pisick with the foul. Second team foul on Fresno Pacific. First foul on Pisick. Iami passing it in for the Vikings over to Duff. Back out to Iami. Cross court to Bland. Looks to shoot. Hesitation move, goes baseline, passes it over to Duff. Duff for three, and she hits it. So the Vikings are 2-for-3 early on from the three-point line, providing all the points from downtown. The Vikings lead 6-2 here as Malasarte looks for the screen. She gets the screen for Alvarez. Hesitation move, great move by Alvarez. Tries to pass it over to Faber, but that one's knocked out of bounds. Katrina Jamaica comes in the game now. She replaces Bobby Westendorf. Castelleda is coming in the game now. She replaces Bland. And stolen by Castelleda on the transition. Gets it over to Duff, over to Rogers, and the easy layup up and in. Great job by Wester to capitalize off the turnover as Malasarte rushes it down and off the front rim and rebounded by Castelleda. And Bland is by herself over and she puts it up and in, 10-2. Vikings are on top early, fast start by Western. Cross running it down. And Pisick back over to Alvarez. Pisick with the screen. Back out to Pisick, deep two, that one's up and in. Cassie Pisick, 13 points on the night yesterday, and she is now on the board. 10-4 Vikings lead as Iyama dribbles it up, guarded by Cross. She loses the ball, and that one is stolen by Pisick. On transition, she slows it up, gets it over the Cross, over to Alvarez, and they're gonna try to run a set here. 4:33 left in the first quarter. Vikings lead Fresno Pacific. Alvarez for three, in and out, rebound, Rogers. Gets it over to Iami, she finds Castelleda. And Jamaica puts it up, misses it, puts it up, misses it. Knocked out of bounds. Good defense by Pisick, but Western will regain possession. And a timeout on the floor as Western leads Fresno Pacific by a score of 10-4. We'll be right back. And welcome back to Western Washington University Wiku Court for the last game. The West Region Crossover Classic here, Western Washington facing Fresno Pacific. Vikings lead the Sunbirds 10-4 early on. Jamaica tries to get it down to Rogers. He hits the, shoots the mid-range shot off the front rim. Rebound, Fresno Pacific. And on the court now for Fresno Pacific, Kiyomani with the turnover, as well as Kate McClard. And also back in the game now is Isla Faber and Kaylee Bach. This redshirt senior is also in the game for Fresno Pacific. And Rachel Berry. So all five non-starters on the court for Fresno Pacific. And for Western, Molly Olson with the ball. She's now in the game now. Schwecki is back in the game for Western. Over to Duff. Duff uses her right hand. Mid-range shot up off the front rim and out. Rebound Fresno Pacific on the transition. Rachel Berry gets it into the paint, kicks it back out. And Kiyomani gets in the paint, throws up a shot, and she draws the foul, so she's going to shoot too. So Molly Wilson with the foul. That's her first personal second team foul. Barbara Kiyomani hits the first free throw. Kiyomani, the senior, at a transfer from Sierra College, originally from Sacramento, California. And she makes it 10-6. Western with the lead. Full court pressure. Molly Olson able to get loose. Dribbles it through. Castaneda trying to get it down to Schwecki, but they're going to get Schwecki with the offensive foul. So that was good defense by Kaylee Bach on that play. Schwecki was trying to get position. Schwecki is in early foul trouble. First quarter here, and she already has two fouls. She's replaced by Westendorf. Bland comes in the game now for Olson. And LoCastro comes in the game for Eileen Faber. They will have the ball here. She's going to pass it in. Rachel Berry, the sophomore, dribbles it down, guarded by Bland. Look for the screen. Good fight through by Bland. Good defense by the Vikings here. And great shot by Kiyomani, and she hits the shot. It is now 10-8. Looks like they're going to get Fresno Pacific with the foul. That's going to be their third personal. Kaylee Bach, first personal. Castaneda. Sit down to Dykstra, over to Rogers, kicks it back out to Bland for three. And off the side iron, and they're going to get Avery Dykstra with the foul. That's the fourth team foul on the Vikings. So next foul will be free throws no matter what, unless it's an offensive foul for Fresno Pacific. Berry dribbles it down, puts it up, misses it, deflected, regained by LoCastro. She gets it over to Kiyomani, guarded by Bland, looks for the screen. And McClard puts it up, blocked by Rogers. Rebound. Actually, that was the block by Westendorf. And Castaneda puts up the lefty off the iron. And rebounded by Fresno Pacific. LoCastro over the Berry. Mid-range shot off the front rim. But nobody boxed out Kaylee Bach. But they were able to take that one away. So good hustle by Western. Castaneda over to Westendorf. Backs her man down. Over to Dykstra for three, off the rim, and they're going to get Westendorf with the foul. Both teams struggling from the field goal range, 25% for Western Washington, 20% by Fresno Pacific. And with the loose ball foul, Julia LaCastro is going to shoot two. She is a senior from Fresno City High School in Fresno, California, so local. First shot, up and in. Emma Duff and Danny Iwami in the game now, replacing Westendorf and Castaneda. Second shot for the Sunbirds. Off the back iron and up and in. So tie game now, 10-10. 1:39 left in this first quarter as Iwami gets to the hole. Great pass to Rogers, lefty up and in. Great assist by Iwami, great finish by Rogers. Vikings are back on top, 12-10. As Haley Betancourt hit with the offensive foul. See on this play, great transition move. No look pass to Rogers, and she puts the lefty up and in. Great move by the junior to get it to the sophomore. Great job by Iwami again to get into the paint. She misses the attempt, rebound Fresno Pacific, and they're on the transition again. Kiyomani slows it down. Fresno Pacific likes to run here, 80 points last night. Great move, great take by Fresno Pacific. Kiyomani with the bucket. She now has 6 points, she leads all scorers. Iwami over to Duff. Looks to try to pass the blam, but instead dribbles it into the paint. Over to Dykstra, uses her right hand. Passes it back out to Iwami, over to Duff. Duff for three, follows her own shot, deflected, and it's gonna stay here. So, there's a 1 second differential between shot clock and game clock. So Alvarez, Melzarte, and Cross are back in the game four. Fresno Pacific is Bland's gonna pass it in for the Vikings. Iwami trying to get in, trying to get open, but they end up passing it to Duff, and Iwami ends up getting the ball here. Back up to Bland, pump fakes. Good pass over to Rogers, puts it up off the front rim, and that one was rebounded by Pisick. Melzarte. Hezos. It's over to Pisick, and she puts it up and in. So 4 seconds left, and that one is deflected out of bounds. And there's only 0.2 seconds left. They're going to put another 0.4 seconds now. So there's going to be 0.4 seconds left, so enough time to just grab and shoot here for the Vikings. They try to pass it down to Rogers, and that is the end of the first quarter. So Fresno Pacific, after trailing 10-4, they went on a 10-2 run to end the quarter, and that's how we're going to end this first quarter. So the Sunbirds lead the Vikings 14-12. We'll be right back after this quarter break. Welcome back to Western Washington University, Weku Court, for the last game of this tournament here. The West Region Crossover Classic, Seattle Pacific, Humboldt State, Fresno Pacific. and the host of the tournament, Western Washington. Fresno Pacific leads 14-12. Let's go over some first quarter stats here. Leading all scorers is Barbara Kiomani with six, two for two from the field, 2 for 2 from the line. 5 points for Emma Duff for the Vikings. And with 32 points last night, the Vikings have done a great job of getting Malzarte off the board. So far, she only has two. So Bree Alvarez tries to call a screen, gets it into the paint, back out the cross, guarded by Iami. Great job by Iami to fight through the screen. Free throw shot up and in. Great defense, even better offense by Fresno Pacific. 16-12, they lead here early on in the second quarter. Iami gets a screen by Rogers, looks to shoot, passes it out to Duff, over to Dykstra. And over to Bland, 15 seconds left on the shot clock here. Over to Rogers, and she puts it up and in. Great job by Rogers, the move without the ball. She gets the easy layup. 6 points on the night for Rogers so far. Vikings are down by two. As Alvarez gets into the paint, she puts it up and in. So a quick bucket by Fresno Pacific. 18-14, they lead as Iami gets it down quickly. She's calling for a play here. Cross court to Duff. Pump fakes. Gets it over to Rogers. Back out to Duff. Into the paint. Over to Iami for three. In and out, but rebound Dykstra over to Bland. Brand new shot clock, but they're going to get Bland with a travel. That is the ninth turnover for the Vikings so far. Malzarte is guarded by Bland. 18-14, Malzarte. That one is deflected and stolen by Westendorf over to Bland on the fast break. Great job by Bland to dribble through, but she misses the layup. Rebound, Malzarte. She's dribbling it down here. Dribbles it off her foot, trying to go between her legs. That one's picked up by Westendorf, and it looks like Rogers is going to have the easy layup. Rogers now with 8 points, game high. Vikings are down by two, 18-16. Cross dribbles it in, and they're going to get her with the charge. Great positioning by Bland to take the charge there. Cross with the foul. That is her second personal. First team foul of the quarter. Vikings look to tie or take the lead here. Bland dribbling down for the Vikings, the junior. Over to Dykstra. Over to Westendorf. Westendorf almost took too many steps there. Rogers, double teamed below. Fights through it, over to Bland for three. Off the rim, and that one is rebounded by LaCastro. Over to Malzarte. Gets it over to Alvarez. Baseline shot up and in, 20-16, Fresno Pacific leads. Alvarez, that's her fourth bucket, her fourth point, second bucket. Foul on the floor here. And they're gonna get Megan Sherritt. Barbara Imani in the game now. Castaneda also in the game. And actually, that last foul was on Julia LaCastro. That's her first personal, and that's the second team foul of the quarter. Castaneda over to Iami. Over to Castaneda, trying to get it down to Westendorf, looking to get it down to Westendorf. Good positioning by Westendorf. She puts it up and in. Both teams trading buckets here. Vikings again down by two. Malzarte rushes it down, puts up the lefty shot, and that one is off the backboard, rebounded by Rogers. Iami looks for the screen by Rogers. Another screen again. Fresno Pacific looks to be switching screens here. So if you could get Rogers on Melzarte, that'd be the best case scenario. And some subs on the floor. Rachel Berry, Kate McClard, and Isla Faber in the game four. Fresno Pacific, good spin move by Yami. She puts the righty up and in, offhand. Yami is a lefty, puts a right-handed layup up and in, and it is tied here at 20. And great job by Fresno Pacific to just rush it down, score a bucket. Rachel Berry, and that tie score was short-lived. Fresno Pacific now up 22-20. Emma Duff at the checkout table, as well as Bland. Castaneda looks for the screen by Rogers. Cross-court to Yami. Another cross-court to Castaneda. Passed in, stolen by Fresno Pacific. Rachel Berry, again, looks to rush it down for the Sunbirds. And that one is going to be a foul on Rogers. You can see on this replay, great job by Iyami to use the spin move, use the righty, get it off the glass and up and in. Yami, the junior, with the bucket. But at the line, we got Eile Faber with the first shot up and in, the sophomore from Germany. Dykstra and Rogers out, and Yami out as well. Duff Bland in the game now, as well as Jamaica. And Faber puts full shots up and in. Fresno Pacific now up by four. As Bland. Let's see Bland. Sends Duff right back out. Looks like Jamaica took too many steps on that play. Tenth turnover by the Vikings so far, halfway through the second quarter. As Cross is back in the game now for Fresno Pacific. She replaces Kiyomani. Barry's dribbling it down, rushing it down again. Fresno Pacific proven to be a running team. Pizek's shot just grazes the front rim, rebounded Bland, and that one intercepted by Cross, but she goes out of bounds. Great whereabouts by Cross. As you can see there, great bait and switch by Cross, but the Vikings will retain possession. Castaneda passes it in. Almost backcourt violation. Castaneda all by herself on the right side. She puts the righty up and in. Great job by Castaneda. Absorb the contact. Get the shot, and that one a little out of control by Berry. She tries to pass it to Cross, and that one goes out of bounds. Eight turnovers by Fresno Pacific. There's going to be a timeout on the floor, media timeout here. We're at Wiku Court on the campus of Western Washington University, the last game of the tournament here. The West Region Crossover Classic. Fresno Pacific leads Western Washington 24-22. We'll be right back. And welcome back to Wiku Court on the campus of Western Washington University. For this West Region crossover classic matchup between the Fresno Pacific and Western Washington University, Sunbirds lead the Vikings by two here, 24-22. We are halfway through the second quarter. Both teams struggling with turnovers early. Great whereabouts by Duff. She puts it up and in. Vikings doing a better job today of finishing, and they tie this thing up at 24. Now Zarte gets it over to Cross, who gets in the paint. Mid-range shot off the rim. Faber. Actually, Faber. My apologies on that one. You can see on this replay, Duff waited for the play to resolve here. She absorbs a contact, puts it up and in. Great play by Emma Duff. And that shot by Pizik misses everything. That one goes out of bounds, so the Vikings with the possession. Pizik is out of the game now. Bach back in the game for the Sunbirds. Bland, guarded by Malzarte. Westendorf asks for the ball, faces up, puts it up, it misses, deflected, but Duff is right there. Good hustle by Emma Duff. Tries to see Castaneda back door, gets it over to Westendorf. Great pass to Jamaica, and that one is up and in. That's Katrina Jamaica's first bucket of the ball game. Great assist by Westendorf. Now Zarte for three, off the front rim. Rebound Cross. Reset of the shot clock here. Guarded by Castaneda, Cross. Looks to get something going for the Sunbird. She gets it in, mid-range shot, up and in, and she draws the foul. She's gonna shoot one, and one shot for Ashley Cross. This play, you could see Duff looking to go back door, gets it over to Westendorf. She loses the ball, but she's able to find Jamaica. Great play by the lone senior on the court for Western. Bobby Westendorf with the assist as Cross finishes the and one shot. She gets the three-point play, and Fresno Pacific is now up by one, 27-26, as Westendorf comes out of the game. Kelsey Rogers back in the game for Western. Kelsey Rogers with a game-high 8 points so far. Bland over to Duff. And Iyami puts a three up and in. Iwami. Now with 8 points, she's tied for the team high with Rogers as Alvarez gets it over to Malzarte. Malzarte asks for the screen. Cross court pass. Alvarez pump fakes, shoots the layup three. That is rebounded by Duff over to Bland for the Iwami. Iwami, hesitation move, gets over to Jamaica, passes it over the Rogers, puts it up, she misses it, rebound. Fresno Pacific over Malzarte to Alvarez, who runs it. McLeod off the back rim, and great box out by Western. It looks like that box out was by Iwami over to Jamaica, and that one's stolen by Malzarte. Malzarte for three, off the back rim. Rebounded, Bland over to Jamaica, two on one, over to Rogers, back and forth, over to Jamaica. So Jamaica, the Rogers to Jamaica. And great fast break opportunity. Take advantage of the two on one by the Vikings. They are up by four here, 31-27. Jamaica now with her fourth bucket of the ball game. Malzarte gets it over to Alvarez. Looks for the screen. Tries to pass it down here. And Kaylee Bach draws the foul. Katrina Jamaica with the foul. You can see on this replay, great job by Jamaican Rogers. That's what you practice every day. The three-on-two, two-on-one drills. And it pays dividends for him. Bach misses the first free throw. Molly Olson in the game now for Western. She replaces Bland. McClard out of the game now for the Sunbirds. She's replaced by Kiomani. Second shot up and in. Three-point ball game here. And after the made free throw, Pizik replaces Bach. It's Molly Olson dribbles it down for the Vikings. Jamaica over the Rogers, and she misses the layup. Contested layup. Malzarte dribbles it down over to Pizik. Back out to Malzarte. Malzarte, their 32-point performance last night. She is 1 for 7 from the field, 0 for 4 from the three-point line so far. Vikings have done a great job. Fresno Pacific has also done a great job of picking up the slack here. And shot clock violation. Great defensive stand by the Vikings. 42 seconds left in the second quarter. There's going to be a sub here. Kaylee Betancourt in the game now, as well as Crystal Gutierrez for Fresno Pacific. Full court press here, full court man-to-man press. Molly Olson over the Iwami. Back over to Duff Iwami. Olson over to Jamaica for three, off the back iron. And that one was contested. Looks like they're going to get Fresno Pacific with the foul. Cassie Pizik with the foul. That's her third personal. She's now in foul trouble. She'll probably sit the start of the third quarter. The Vikings can get the last shot of the quarter here. Iwami calls a screen by Jamaica. She pushes her back out. Now calls for it and then gets it into the paint over the Rogers. Puts it up, in and out. Duff with the rebound. Somehow puts it up and she draws the foul. Great hustle play by Emma Duff, and she's going to get two free throws with 1 second left. So 1.2 seconds left in the second quarter, and Emma Duff is going to go to the line here. Emma Duff's going to shoot two. Emma Duff's first shot is up and in. Emma Duff, the sophomore, as a freshman, she averaged 19 minutes a game. 6.7 points and 3.5 rebounds. Second shot. And actually there's 0.5 seconds left on the clock now as it was deflected out of bounds by Western. So the second shot was missed and they're not gonna get a shot off. So the Vikings with a tough first quarter. They regained the possession, regained the lead, and they are up 32-28 going into halftime. There's going to be a 15-minute break here at Wiku Court. So we will be back here in a few minutes. So when we come back here, it will be the start of this third quarter here in the last game of the West Region Crossover Classic.
Time for the halftime entertainment. This is
Oh, is this the ultimate sign of sportsmanship right here? Wow. Okay, we've got five left and only four chairs. The music has hit, and we are going to do a little dribbling again around the chairs. Here we go.
Welcome back to Western Washington University Weku Court. Second half action underway here. Vikings lead 32-28. First shot missed by the Vikings as Alvarez puts it up and in for Fresno Pacific. 32-30, they trail by two. A little bit of miscommunication there by the Vikings, but Bland able to dribble the ball down. Guarded by Cross over to Hiwami. Bland over to Duff. Over to Hiwami, 8 seconds left on the shot clock here. Bland looks to get it down low to Westendorf. Tries to put up a shot here. They're gonna get Schwecki for stepping out of bounds, so turnover by the Vikings. Let's go over some first half stats here. Leading all scorers, we have 8 apiece by Emma Duff, Danny Iwami, and Kelsey Rogers. 6 points apiece by Alvarez and Kiyomani for Fresno Pacific as Alvarez puts up the shot, misses it, rebound. Westendorf and Iwami on the transition, goes righty. Could have had a layup there. Decides to get it over to Westendorf, and they're going to get Westendorf with the travel. So Kelsey Rogers is coming back in the game now for Western, replacing Westendorf. And Pisick, who started the half, is now out of the game. She's replaced by Kaylee Bach for Fresno Pacific. Malzarte is dribbling it down for Fresno Pacific. Malzarte, 32 points last night, 7 3-pointers made, but only 2 points tonight. 15 seconds left on the shot clock. It's Cross does the crossover. That one is blocked by Kelsey Rogers, and she regains it. Over to Bland, who dribbles it back out, guarded by Malzarte, Iwami. Schwecki's trying to get position, and they're gonna get Julia LaCastro, the senior, with the hold. And we can see the replay here by Cross. Great block by Rogers, and she's able to retain the possession. Rogers, 8 points so far. Schwecki trying to get position. Over to Bland, Bland for three, and she hits it. 3-pointer by Bland. She is now on the board, 3 points for her on the night. 35-30, Western up to their biggest lead since the first quarter when they went up 10-4. Malzarte, all by herself, calls for the screen from LaCastro. High screen, she somehow gets through it. She puts up the left-handed shot, and she is hammered by Iwami. So Malzarte is going to go to the line for two. You see on this replay here, Duff. It's over to Rogers. Rogers looking it down to get it down to Schwecki. Schwecki double-teamed. She finds Bland, the open man, for three. So great all-around teamwork by the Vikings. Malzarte to the line. First shot. Up and in. Jessica Malzarte, the sophomore from Carson, California, Bishop Montgomery High School.
Lock out. Push back.
So far this season, averaging 32 points a game. Only one game on the board here, and she had 32 points last night. 4 points on a night tonight. 35-32. Vikings lead by three here. 7:23 left in the third quarter. Iwami calls for the screen by Rogers. Doesn't use it. Goes to the right hand. Puts up the left. He misses it. Schwecki right there for the rebound. She puts it up and in. And one for Schwecki. And she now is on the board now. See on this replay, Iwami gets into position. She gets a good shot off. Schwecki right there with the rebound. Puts it up and in. Gets the foul. And she adds another point with the free throw. The Vikings up by six here. 38-32. Schwecki with her first 3 points of the ball game. She's only played about 7 minutes tonight due to foul trouble. She picked up 2 quick fouls in the first quarter. And there's going to be a foul on the play here. Hibba Duff, she now has 2 fouls. It's going to send Kaylee Bach to the line. Haley Bach, redshirt senior from Rialto, California. The transfer from Montana Tech hits the first free throw. Rachel Berry, the sophomore from Clovis, California, in the game now. She's going to replace Jessica Malzarte. Kaylee Bach with her second free throw from the rim. Camera angle, that's up and in. Cross picking up Iwami pretty early here. And they're going to get Kaylee Bach with the push. So as Anna Schwecki's been trying to get position here in the second half, she endured some pushing, some holding by the Sunbirds. She's very persistent as Bach is out of the game now. She's replaced by Faber. That one deflected. And it looks like they're going to get on the loose ball. They're going to get Lexi Bland with the hold. So that's her first personal, team foul number 3. A lot of fouls early on here in the second quarter. Bland guarding Berry, and she calls for the screen by Faber. And they're going to get her with the offensive foul. Berry definitely extended her arm in that play. As Bland is able to draw the charge here. So that's Berry's first personal, 14 fouls. So Vikings will be shooting free throws on any foul for the rest of the quarter besides a Fresno Pacific offensive foul here. As Bland pump fakes as they switch on that play. Iwami puts it up, misses everything. Good hustle by Duff, but Fresno Pacific ball. On the court for Fresno Pacific, we got Barry Faber, LoCastro, Cross, and Alvarez. As Faber gets it over to Alvarez. Alvarez for 3, off the front rim. Cross with the rebound and up and in. Great hustle by Cross. Ashley Cross, the junior from Detroit, Michigan, Clovis West High School, as Duff with the 3, and she puts it up and in. So good response by the Vikings here, and they are now up by 5. Duff now with 11 points, and they're going to get. Looks like they're going to get Rachel Berry with another charge here. That's their second personal, 5th team foul. You can see on this replay here. Iwami able to draw the charge. Bland out of the game now. Molly Olson in the game. Berry comes out of the game for Berry and Alvarez come out of the game now for Fresno Pacific. Malzarte back in the game now. And another offensive foul on the court here. Kate McClard also in the game, the freshman from Hanford High School for Fresno Pacific, but they're going to get Schwecki with the offensive foul. She now has 3 fouls. Looks like Jamaica is going to probably take her position on the next dead ball as Malzarte dribbles down, gets it over the cross, fronted the post by Schwecki. Great defense by the junior, not allowing LoCastro position. Rogers now on LoCastro. Cross guarded by Olson. Gets into the paint. Puts it up off the front rim. Rebounded by Duff. 41-36. Vikings lead halfway through the third quarter. And good deflection by Cross. And Faber ends up, actually check that, LoCastro ends up with it. Puts up the layup, misses it. Rebounded by Cross. She misses it. And it looks like Faber is going to go to the line. She's going to shoot 2. Emma Duff, that's her third personal, so some foul trouble here. And there's a media timeout on the floor. Vikings lead Fresno Pacific by a score of 41-36. We'll be right back. And welcome back to Western Washington University, Wiku Court. Western Washington University Vikings playing Fresno Pacific. They lead 41-36 halfway through the third quarter here. Some sweet hairline playing by Neil Diamond. Emma Duff leads all scorers with 11 points on the night. Two made three-pointers, but at the line, for Fresno Pacific. Eileen Faber with the first free throw up and in. Second shot, in and out, rebound, Rogers. Castaneda in the game now for Western, as well as Jamaica. Replacing Bland, actually replacing Duff and Schwecki, who both have three fouls. Rogers gets it down. Gets it down to Rogers, but they're gonna get, actually Rogers got it down to Jamaica, but they're gonna get Jamaica with a 3-second violation. So turnover by the Vikings, that is their 18th turnover on the night. LeCastro over to Malzarte, crosses over, good hesitation move, somehow finds McClard, who misses everything, and LeCastro tries to save it, but she's touches the blue, so Vikings with the ball here. Molly Olson dribbling it down, the freshman over to Castaneda, and they're going to get Fresno Pacific with the foul. So Castaneda is going to go to the line for two. Alvarez coming in the game now. She's going to replace McClard. And Bland's going to replace Olson. Castaneda is going to go to the line. She's going to shoot two. Gracie Castaneda. She's the redshirt sophomore here. First shot, up and in. Dykstra coming in the game now. She's going to replace Emma Duff. Castaneda, as a freshman, averaged 10.6 points a game and three rebounds. She attended Arlington High School, part of the Northwest Athletic Conference. Up here in Northwestern Washington. Malzarte dribbles it down fast, puts it up, tries to draw contact. She misses it. Rogers gets the rebound. Rogers with her fifth rebound. Castaneda gets it over to Jamaica, and she is fouled. So Jamaica is going to go to the line. 4-2, 43-37. Vikings lead here. Katrina Jamaica, the freshman from Nooksack Valley. Another person who played in a Northwest Athletic Conference up north here. She averaged 19 points and 11 rebounds to help her team to the state tournament, named the most valuable player of the Northwest Conference, and was a 1A first team all-state selection at Nooksack Valley. She hits both free throws. The Vikings with their biggest lead of the game, 45-37 here. 3:45 left in the third quarter. Both teams in the bonus. Alvarez gets it over to Faber, and she puts it up and in. Bland. Jamaica. Waits for the play to resolve. Good hustle by Faber. Good defense, but they're gonna get. Okay, Omani with the foul. She now has four fouls. Actually, no, check that. Looks like they're gonna get Cassie Pissick with the foul, the junior. Jamaica's going to shoot two. Jamaica again with the free throw. Crossing the game now for Pizik. Kaylee Bach in the game now as well. Second shot up and in, 47-39. Third quarter here, 3:16 left. Malzarte dribbles it down. Get over to Faber, cross. Gets it into the paint, gets it back out. Alvarez, 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Back out to Faber for three, actually not for three, for the mid-range shot, and she hits it. So the Sunbirds down by six now. Both teams trading buckets here. Bland guarded by Malzarte. Rogers calls for the ball, faces up with the step through, and she gets it in and out. Good move by Rogers. Just puts a little bit too much on it. Cross puts it up, misses it, but she's going to draw the foul. Castaneda. Castaneda, the foul. That's her first personal. First shot off the front rim. Castaneda out of the game now. Jamaica and Dykstra. Yami, Schwecki, and Duff back in the game now. With the exception of Westendorf, starters on the floor here for the Vikings as the second shot is up and in. 47-42. Bland dribbles it down. Guarded by guarded by Malzarte. Duff looks for the screen. Guarded by Faber. Iwami. Over to Bland. Bland for three, and she hits it with 7 seconds left on a shot clock. Lexi Bland with a three-point bucket. Cross with the attempt. And they're going to get Rogers with the block. Faber to the line. She's going to shoot two. See on this replay here. Great job by Bland, right at the top of the three-point line. About a couple feet behind it, too. She hits it. First shot by Faber, up and in.
Hook your foot, push back.
Second shot, up and in. Nine points for Faber. And they're going to get Schwecki with the travel. So 19 turnovers now for the Vikings. 17, actually only 11 turnovers for Fresno Pacific, but the Vikings with a six-point lead, playing more aggressive. Alvarez puts it up. She misses. Rebound. Vikings and on to transition. Yami. Over to Duff, to Bland. Rogers calls for it. Help defense. Iwami off the front rim. Rebounded cross on the transition. Crosses it over. Iwami tries to draw the charge, but gets it over to Alvarez for three, and she hits it. That's her ninth point of the ball game. That's her first three. Sunburns They trail by three now as Duff for three. Off the front rim, but she follows her own shot, and that one is knocked out of bounds by Cross. It's a good hustle by Emma Duff. 43 seconds left in the quarter. 13 seconds is the difference between a shot clock and the game clock. As Castaneda comes in for Iwami. You can see here, great hustle, causing Cross to knock the ball out of bounds. And Duff, guarded by Barry, over to Rogers. Rogers off the front rim, misses. So rebound, 3 second differential. Barry drives into the key, over to Melzarte, she misses. As hot as Melzarte was yesterday, she's cold today. 22 seconds left in the third quarter, and there's a jump ball, possession error points towards Fresno Pacific. LaCastro comes into the game. She's going to replace Kaylee Bach. So the Sunbirds can get the last shot of the quarter here. And LaCastro draws the foul. And it's not going to be on Schwecki here. Looks like the foul. Castaneda with the foul. That's her second personal. Iwami coming in mid-game now. As LaCastro hits the first free throw. She replaces Schwecki. And that's a good move by Dolfo to get Schwecki out of there before she could potentially pick up a fourth foul, so she has two fouls to give here in the fourth quarter coming up here, but it looks like Iwami's gonna dribble it down for the Vikings, and Western's gonna get the last shot of the quarter if everything goes right here. 50-48, Vikings lead by two. Rogers with the screen. Iwami looking to get something going. 3 seconds left. Bland has to put up something. She doesn't get it off in time. So we go to the fourth quarter here as the Vikings lead the Sunbirds by a score of 50-48. We'll be back in just a moment. Welcome back to Western Washington University on the campus here, Wiku Court. Vikings lead Fresno Pacific by a score of 50-48. Let's go over some stats through three quarters here. Emma Duff leads all scorers with 11 points, 4-for-8 from the field goal. And 2-of-4 from the three-point line. She also has 10 rebounds, so a double-double for Duff, leading Fresno Pacific. We got Faber with 9 and Alvarez with 9. So Bland, guarded by Barry, over to Castaneda. Gets it over to Iwami, over to Rogers. Rogers with the mid-range shot, and she puts it up and in. Rogers. 5-for-11 from the field. She now has 10 points, 5 rebounds, 2 blocks to go with it. Melzarte with the layup. She puts it in. Melzarte now, 6 points on the night. She's had a tough night from the field. But as she showed yesterday, she could get hot at any moment. And it is 52-50 Western leads, and they're going to get Malzarte with the push. That's her second personal. First team foul of the quarter. You can see here on this replay, Wami passes out to Rogers, and Rogers able to square up her body even though she was fading away. She puts it up and in. Rogers now with 11 points, actually 10 points on the night. Wami and the Castaneda trying to get something going for the Vikings here. Bland over to Wami, who drives the baseline, puts it up, misses, rebound LeCastro for Fresno Pacific, and she's dribbling it down herself. But then she stops, gets it to Malzarte, who's calling for the screen. Faber, and she is fouled by Emma Duff, and that is her fourth personal foul. See on this replay here, Duff tries to hedge, but just gets too much of Malzarte, and that is the first personal foul of the quarter, but that is Emma Duff's fourth personal, and Schwecki replaces her. Schwecki has three fouls herself. Malzarte with the ball here, guarded by Castaneda, looking to get some space. Good defense by Western here. Barry calls for the screen by LeCastro. Good hedge by Schwecki. To regain the possession, Barry, the mid-range shot, Schwecki with the rebound. Gets it over to Bland, and they're on transition here. Castaneda gets it down to Rogers. Rogers cross-court to Iwami. Iwami for three, in and out, rebound Barry. And they're going to get Castaneda with a foul. That's her third personal. Fresno Pacific beat Seattle Pacific yesterday 80-69. Vikings lost to Humboldt State 58-50. And then earlier today, Humboldt State beat Seattle Pacific 79-77. Two free throws at the end put it away for Humboldt State. It's cross for three and she misses everything. Rogers with the rebound. Rogers gets it over to Bland. Down to Castaneda. Hesitation move, stops, gives it over to Schwecki. Good pump fake, gets it into paint, and great pass to Rogers, but they're gonna get Schwecki. Looks like Schwecki with the travel. An unfortunate turnover, because she saw Rogers cutting back door, and she had the open layup, but Schwecki with the turnover. As Alvarez actually checked that, Pizik. Puts it up, she misses it. Bland, over to Castaneda. Bland, over to Rogers, faces up. Over to Schwecki, back to Rogers. Rogers, mid-range shot, up and in. Rogers having a great game tonight. 12 points for the sophomore, 6-12 from the field goal range.
Lock out.
And that was a deep two by Cross. Good response. That ball was almost stolen by Fresno Pacific, but Bland was able to come up with it. She tries to pass it to Schwecki, but that one is hit out of bounds. See on this replay here, Rogers looks to get it down to Schwecki, but Schwecki wisely gets it back out to Rogers, and Rogers with a deep two. Kiyomani in the game now. She replaces Alvarez for Western. An illegal screen on the play here. Anna Schwecki with her fourth personal, and they're going to bring back in Westendorf to replace her. So four fouls apiece for Emma Duff and Anna Schwecki. And they might be sitting until probably about the 3-minute mark. Malzarte gets a screen for LeCastro. Pizik for three, off the front rim, almost rolls it in, but rebound, Castaneda gets it over to Bland. 6 minutes and 30 seconds left. Vikings up by two here. Melzarte looks for the screen by Westendorf. Westendorf asks for the ball down low. Gets it, squares up, cross court pass. Castaneda off the back rim, rebounded Melzarte. Melzarte, hesitation move, great move by Melzarte. Puts it up, and one. Melzarte, great ball handling move by the sophomore. She's able to get the contact and hit the mid-range shot. Castaneda now has four fouls, so three Vikings with four fouls, and you can see on that replay. Great whereabouts by Melzarte. Melzarte now with 9 points on the night. Iwami in the game now. She replaces Castaneda. Westendorf passes in to Bland. So Fresno Pacific takes the lead, 55-54. We're going on 6 minutes left in the ball game here. Dykstra tries to go baseline, guarded by Melzarte, and great steal by Cross. 2-1, fakes it, puts it up, misses the layup, and Jamaica's in the game now for the Vikings, and she draws the foul. Barbara Chiomani, that's her first personal. Great steal by Ashley Cross on that play, though. Iwami over to Dykstra, and she took too many steps. Turnover, Vikings. Vikings, 23 turnovers on the night. Westendorf out of the game now, as well as Dykstra. Kelsey Rogers back in the game now. Emma Duff with four fouls is in the game for Western. She's going to have to play careful. Guarding the aggressive Ashley Cross. Likes to slash into the paint. Great defensive player. She's going to have to be careful here. As well as anyone who's guarding Melzarte. Melzarte into the paint. Passes it out to Pizik. Over to Kiwami. Misses. Rebound Rogers. Over to Bland. Bland wisely slows it up. And they're going to get Melzarte with the foul. Melzarte now with three fouls. Both teams one foul away from being in the bonus. Iwami gets it into Molly Olson, who's now in the game now. The freshman guarded by Melzarte gets over the Rogers. Waiting for the play to develop. Good whereabouts by Cross. Olson. Gets it down low to Duff. Faces up spin move. And they're going to get her with the travel. So we're going to go to a media timeout here. Close one here at Wiku Court on campus of Western Washington University. Last game of the West Region Crossover Classic. Fresno Pacific leads Western by a score of 55-54. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Wiku Court on the campus of Western Washington University. Last game of the West Region Crossover Classic. Fresno Pacific leads Western Washington University by a score 55-54. game earlier today. Humboldt State beat Seattle Pacific 79-77, so both games today have been very close. Closer than yesterday. Malzarte draws the foul on Iwami. Iwami now has two fouls, and that is the fifth team foul on the Vikings, so two free throws for Malzarte. And Malzarte now in double digits. Awesome camera view we have here from behind the backboard. Second free throw is up and in. So Fresno Pacific up by three. Malzarte now leading the Vikings 57-54. And actually Malzarte now has 11 points. She leads the Sunbirds in scoring. But Bland was able to draw the foul on Cross. So she's going to go to the line for two. First shot off the front rim, missed. Lexi Bland made 27 starts last year. Averaged 5 points and 2 assists a game. Misses both free throws here. Costly free throws, and Malzarte is able to get to the line again as Duff is... Looks like she has fouled out now. She now has 5 fouls, so Duff is going to come out of the game now, and Dolfo calls a timeout here, trying to figure some things out here. The West Region Crossover Classic. Fresno Pacific, they lead Western 57-54. We'll be right back. And welcome back to Weku Court on the campus of Western Washington University. Fresno Pacific leads the Vikings by a score of 57-54. Malzarte is going to line. She's going to shoot two. Malzarte leads the Sunbirds in scoring tonight with 11. She led them with scoring last night with 32. And even though she's had a tough time from the field today, she is 5 for 5 from the line and has played some great defense. Malzarte's shot is up and in. 58-54, 4:24 left. You can see a look at the Viking bench here. Second shot, up and in. Malzarte now with 13 points on the night. Good players show that when they don't shoot well, they do other things well to contribute, as Alvarez blocks the shot. Castaneda, and rebound by Malzarte, but they get her with the charge. So Malzarte with the charge here. You can see here, she didn't see Bland coming at all. And I don't think Malzarte would have got called for the foul, but she put out her arm, and when she puts out her arm, it's an easy call for the refs here. 4 fouls on Malzarte. Both teams have a number of players in foul trouble tonight, with Emma Duff fouling out for the Vikings. Iwami over to Bland, gets over to Schwecki. Schwecki double teamed over to Rogers. Iwami pump fakes, gets it in over the Schwecki, but out of bounds. Good pass by Iwami off the hands of Schwecki. 59-54, 3:49 left. And that is the Vikings' 25th turnover of the night. Malzarte guarded by Bland. with the travel. So the Sunbirds with 13 turnovers on the night now. Alzarte responsible for five of them. And Bland dribbling it down. The Castaneda guarded by Alvarez. That one back out to Bland. They're going to get Bland with the travel. Vikings now with 26 turnovers on the night. Definitely, once the season starts for the Vikings, they have to clean up their turnover margin and also their fouling here as Bland runs in the cross.
Western Washington foul call number three.
That's what the first few games of the year are meant for.
At the line shooting for Fresno Pacific, number 24, Ashley Cross.
Ashley Cross shooting for the Viking. Actually, check that for the Sunbirds. Ashley Cross, first shot up and in. And the Sunburns, they have shot well from the line. 85%, 23 of 27 tonight. And it's proven to be the big difference here. It's Ashley Cross, the junior from Detroit, Michigan. Clovis West High School, she puts the second one up and in. That one's deflected and out of bounds. Cross now with 12 points on the night. 4 or 5 from the free throw line. Go with 4 rebounds. Uwami gets it over to Olsen, who's now in the game now. Uwami guarded by Cross. Olsen down to Schwecki. They've been double teaming her all night. She has not had a lot of room to work. Yami, 5 seconds left on the shot clock. They got to get something up here. Good pass to Castaneda. The Vikings are down by 5 here. Great assist by Yami. She has 6 assists on the night. Cross tries to force one up. Rebound to Castaneda over to Olsen. She sees Rogers down the over. They were unable to see her, but Yami puts up the 3 and she hits it. It is a 2-point game now. Fresno Pacific, they lead by 2. Uwami now with 11 points to go with 6 assists on the night. She has 3 three-pointers made. Malzarte isolating, now calls for the screen, doesn't use it, gets into the paint, layup shot, off the back iron, rebounded Olsen. The Vikings have a chance to take the lead here potentially. Uwami looking to get it to Schwecki, and Schwecki draws the foul. That one's going to be on LeCastro, so Schwecki's going to go to the line. She's going to shoot 2. As you can see here, even though Rogers was open on the fast break, once Uwami got down there, she was guarded, but Uwami wasn't, so she took the 3, and she hit it. And Schwecki's going to go to the line for 2. Schwecki's first shot, up and in. Schwecki transferred from University of Colorado, Colorado Springs. And as a sophomore, she averaged 8 points and 7 rebounds a game. Second shot, up and in. We are tied here at 61 with 1 minute and 45 seconds left. Close game here, last matchup of the weekend here in Bellingham. Great response by Fresno Pacific with a deep 2 by Pisick, and it's 63-61. Fresno Pacific with the lead. Schwecki with the screen. Uwami over to Schwecki, puts it up and in. Great pass by Bland to Schwecki, who had position, and we have 1 minute to go, and we're tied here at 63. Rachel Berry over to Malzarte, almost travels over to Alvarez. Back to Berry. Berry calls out a shot here. Here's a play, Alvarez with the mid-range shot. Too long, rebound Bland. 11-second differential. Dolfo calls a timeout. Great comeback by the Vikings here, trailing by 6 points. And we're gonna go to replay here. You can see great positioning by Schwecki and a great pass by Bland. Both juniors here, both have worked together for a couple years. They did a great job getting a bucket when they needed one. We're gonna stay here. Vikings and Fresno Pacific are tied at 63 here. We'll go over the fouls. Pisick, LeCastro, and Malzarte, all three starters for Fresno Pacific, all have 4 fouls. Schwecki has 4 fouls for the Vikings, as well as Castaneda, and Emma Duff has already fouled out. There is a 11-second differential between the game clock and the shot clock. So the Vikings are able to get a shot in 7 seconds here. They could potentially get the last shot, but if it takes more than that or they get an offensive rebound, then Fresno Pacific will have the last shot. But we are tied here at 63 here at Weku Court for the West Region Crossover Classic. Fresno Pacific already on the court. Now the Vikings are out here. Dolfo drawing up a play. And this is something that you practice all the time. What you would do in the last minute of the ball game if it's tied. All different types of scenarios as Uwami looks to get it in, gets it into Castaneda. Gets over to Rogers, double teamed. Over to Castaneda, out the Bland, presses over to Uwami, 14 seconds left on the shot clock. Good defense so far by Fresno Pacific. 9 seconds left, Uwami's gonna take it herself. Puts it up, misses it, rebound Schwecki, and they're gonna get, looks like they're gonna get Cassie Pisick with the foul. She fouls out, and Schwecki's gonna go to the line for two. Isla Faber in the game now for Fresno Pacific. She's gonna replace Cassie Pisick, and Pisick has fouled out. Great hustle by Schwecki with 7 points and 9 rebounds on the night. First shot up and in. Good concentration by the junior. Vikings now lead 64-63. And the second shot is in and out. Rebound, Fresno Pacific, and they call a timeout. And the official thought that Coach Tim Beauregard called a timeout. And he didn't, but now he does. Tough break for Fresno Pacific because they had a play ready off the miss for a potential fast break opportunity. So unfortunately for Fresno Pacific, they did not get to capitalize on that opportunity, but nonetheless, they're gonna get their full time out here, and we're gonna keep it here. Vikings up 64-63, second game of the regular season, last game of the West Region Crossover Classic. First game was yesterday at 5 p.m. where Fresno Pacific beat Seattle Pacific by a score of 80-69. For Jessica Malzarte, 32 points, 7 threes made. In the second game, Humboldt State beat the Western Washington University Vikings by a score of 58-50. And then the game before this, Seattle Pacific and Humboldt State squared off, where Humboldt State edged out Seattle Pacific 79-77 in a very similar situation. With the timeout, Fresno Pacific advances it up to the midway point between the half court and the basket. And we have 14 seconds here. Melzarte gets it over to Cross, who's back in the game now. Cross gets it in, and there is a foul here on the floor. Lexi Bland with the foul. A fortunate break for the Vikings. But Ashley Cross is going to go to the line now. She's going to shoot two. First shot is up and in. So we are tied here at 64, but Cross has one more free throw. Up and in. Timeout on the floor. And it looks like the Vikings will potentially be able to advance this up the half court again, and the Vikings are in the same position as Fresno Pacific was about 4 seconds ago. Actually, it's a 30-second timeout now, guys. So we're going to keep it here. Vikings have 9 seconds left to advance the ball. Actually, they're going to have the ball at half court as well. New rules every year here in Division II women's basketball. Ten-minute quarters being a rule about 3 years ago. Five fouls a quarter. And now we're in there. Bland gets it down to Rogers. Gets it over to Schwecki. Lefty up and in. 3.3 seconds left. And Schwecki with the left-handed shot. And the Vikings are now up 66-65. And great job by Rogers to find Schwecki. And Schwecki puts the left-hander up and in. And the Vikings are now up 66-65. Another timeout on the floor by Fresno Pacific. They will possibly be able to advance this, I'm not sure. But a great job by the Vikings to fight back. And they have a 1-point lead here at home. And I'm not sure what kind of dance that is, but hopefully it's a victory dance here. I don't think I can do that because I just don't have those muscles. 3 seconds left. Western Washington up by 1 point. Malzarte is in the game here. She's going to pass it in and look for her to get the ball right back. She does. 1 second. Shot at the buzzer. And in and out. The Vikings take this one at home. Gutsy performance by both teams. Back and forth battle. And that's a good way to end this West Region crossover classic. Both teams have bright futures ahead of them. The Vikings edge the Sunbirds by a score of 66-65. Winning bucket by Anna Schwecki. With 3 seconds to go, free throws by Ashley Cross with 9 seconds to go to put Fresno Pacific in the lead. But the Vikings get their first victory of the season. They go to 1-1 on the season. Fresno Pacific falls to 1-1 on the season. And let's go over some stats for this ball game, this crazy back and forth ball game that we had here. Let's start with Fresno Pacific leading. Fresno Pacific, we had Ashley Cross with 14 points, 6 of 7 from the free throw line, 4 rebounds, 3 steals. Melzarte, 13 points, 7-for-7 from the free throw line, but for the Vikings, victory by allowing no three-pointers by Melzarte. And Fresno Pacific shot 31% from the field goal range. We're going to go to some earlier replays on the play. Kelsey Rogers, who had a great game with 12 points and 7 rebounds. A couple of mid-range shots by the sophomore. And here, Schwecki did a great job of passing it right back out to Rogers. Schwecki with the winning basket. Great backdoor by Castaneda. That's what it got it all started. Vikings were down by 7 points at that point. And Yami, at that shot, made it within two. And Schwecki with 6 points down the stretch for the Vikings. She finished with 10 points and 9 rebounds, so one rebound shy of a double-double. Emma Duff, who fouled out, still had a great game, 11 points, 10 rebounds. Yami had 11 points, 3 made three-pointers. And Kelsey Rogers, like mentioned before, 12 points, 7 rebounds, so a good all-around effort, distribution from scoring. Thank you for listening to tonight's ball game between Western Washington and Fresno Pacific. Final score, 66-65. The Vikings beat the Sunbirds. I'm Sean Church. Thanks for listening. Have a great night and drive home safely.